Ballet dancers have to be super fit, but they're pushing into new territory and getting very physical in the Australian Ballet's production of Spartacus. It's the story of a slave rebellion in ancient Rome, and dancers worked up a lot of sweat in rehearsal, learning how to fight like gladiators. The man who's got them fighting fit is fight director Nigel Poulton, and he's here with dancers Jake Manga-Kiha and Imogen Chapman. Good morning to you all. How
morning,
are you?
Good.
So, Jake, you have to dance beautifully and fight as well. How hard is it to do both of those things?
Obviously, the physicality seems or feels kind of different, but they're actually quite similar in that they have sequences that you have to learn. One's more practical and one's more for beauty, but in that their sequences are similar, so... it was really easy to learn those sequences off Nigel.
All right, Nigel, can you show us a few of your tricks here? Can you give us a bit of a demo?
Yeah, sure. I mean, the process that I took them through was based in unarmed combat and wrestling. We made a decision very early on to make the fights unarmed rather than use weapons.
Yep.
For a number of dramaturgical and practical reasons. But I spent a lot of time teaching them basic wrestling ideas and then getting them to transition from that. So if Jakey gets a double underhook on me, then he can take my back and then work the escape. Just go and do it.
Oi.
So, and just building up a physical language that's sort of close quarter, and then I needed to start to teach them how to strike and how to work off each other's timing with strikes. And then how to transition back in to close quarter work. And then back to striking.
Well, and that is all so much more physical than we're used to seeing in ballet when you've got your porte-a-bra and all the rest of it. So I remember when Spartacus, when the Australian Ballet first took Spartacus to New York, and Australian Ballet was put on the map because it was so physical and so masculine, and our ballet dancers. What recollections have you got? You would have been little.
Yeah, I was.
As was I.
I was actually about 10, and my parents bought a video, and on it they had Stephen Heathcote doing one of the solos in Spartacus. I remember thinking, wow, like, that'd be amazing too.
And they were just wearing little pieces of leather from memory.
Yes, yeah, it was quite minimal costume, as you can see here.
And Imogen, there's been a bit of a romance in the production. What can you tell me about that?
Oh, there is. There's a great love story that sort of, I think, brings the whole ballet together. It's quite violent and it's quite a cruel story. And the love that Spartacus and Flavia have for each other just carries that story through, and you can really see that and brings the beauty to the ballet.
Physicality and beauty, it's all there. Spartacus continues at the Sydney Opera House until Saturday, November 24th. And for details, go to theaustralianballet.com.au. And now Jake and Imogen will take us to the break with their pas de deux. Thank you all.